Hello, my name is Tara Tomiko and I'm a digital marketing consultant who is obsessed with tools, specifically tools that can help me get my work done a lot quicker. And today I'm going to walk you through how to use Wordtune. Now, Wordtune is an artificial intelligence tool for your writing. So it's an AI writing tool. Before we take a look at it, I do want to let you know that there is a blog post that accompanies this, so you can check the description and you will find the link there. And of course, I'm giving you the link to Wordtune as well. So let's take a look. When you've installed Wordtune Chrome extension, you will be presented with this page. The first thing I recommend you do is to go ahead and unpin it, just like this. And that way it stays there and you can see it here. Now it's already given the sentence and I'm going to show you, we're just going to click on rewrite and you'll see a selection that you can choose from. Go ahead and pick that one and you can see that's pretty much how Wordtune works. But I'm going to walk you through how you can really see the difference when you change your sentences using the rewrite feature. When you click on continue, you will be presented with the pricing page, so you very clearly see what you get in the free version. I will be going through what you get in the premium version as well, but let's just see how you can use this really simple AI tool to help you with your writing. So what I've done is taken the first sentence from my blog post review and I highlight it and then hit on the rewrite icon. Let's see what it gives us. So you can see here you have a selection to choose from, and the difference between the premium and the free version is that everything is lumped into one when you click on the rewrite. So you do get shorter version, which you'll see here, the shortened version of your text, the expand, the formal and the casual, but you do have to read through to find the one that works for you. So let's just take a look and choose one. In the event you're a purist, you might be missing out if you don't utilize an AI writing instrument. Very formal. I believe that if you're an uncommitted purist who refuses to use this, again, I'm not going to read it all, it's formal. You can hear my tone of voice. But I like to write in casual, and so I will just pick something. Let's have a look. The purists who refuse to utilize AI writing instruments are just missing out. That works. So I click on that. And there you have it. Whoopsie, there you have it. It's changed it completely. Now, one of the things you don't get is, and I have spoken to Wordtune about this, is the ability to see your original sentence. Hopefully they will come up with something kind of snazzy so you can have your original sentence there. But, you know, you can hit, Control Z and just undo and go back. But that's just a small thing. But what I really want to show you, because this is super exciting to me, is the suggestion tool. Now, if you go ahead and click on turn on suggestions here, you will notice that the text in here has this lovely underline purple. You see, and when I hover when you hover over the words, you get some suggestions. Now, the reason why I want to show you this is because I've had many people ask me, well, I've got Grammarly, do I need Wordtune? Well, yes, because Grammarly has its job and that is to make sure that your grammar is on point. But Wordtune helps you to express yourself, helps you to write better, clearer. So when you are using Grammarly, this is what you're going to come across when you decide to check for another word. And I've already got it highlighted here, technology. There is no synonym found for the word technology. And this is where Wordtune is very different. When I come along to technology here, it's asking me, hey, do you want to use the word technique or software? So I could say with deep AI software, that makes sense. Why? Because it's within the context of what I've written. So deep AI software, Wordtune knows context and semantics. And that is the key. That is the difference between Grammarly and Wordtune. Wordtune understands what you're writing, what you're trying to say, and so will only offer suggestions that fits what you've just written. I'm going to show you another example. Let's take the word, not communicate, bear with me. Cannot find it compelling. Okay, do you want to say persuasive or convincing? I'm going to say convincing. And let's take the word authentic. believable suggestions. So now this sentence, you know, kind of reads that this nifty but powerful tool helps you express yourself by offering you clear, convincing, and believable suggestions. For me, this is pretty much the same as what I had before, if I take it back, by offering you clear, compelling, and authentic suggestions. As you could see, that didn't take too long for me to do. But when I go to Grammarly now, what I get, and I am in no way, shape, or form dissing Grammarly whatsoever, but you get quite a selection of words. In this case, it cannot find the word compelling, another word for compelling, and it does for authentic, but you have to go through and say, well, which one of these fits? And you read through it again, and authentic, true, authentic, real. Do you see what I mean? So Grammarly has its place. It's great. You can come up with another word, but it's not understanding the context of your sentence whatsoever. So this is really, in a nutshell, how Wordtune works. It's very simple. When you're using the free version, you're going to find this useful. But if you want to up your game, and if you want to save even more time, I absolutely recommend getting the premium version. And let's just go back to the plans that they have here. I really advise you to go for the yearly, because this is how you get the $9.99 a month. If you pay monthly, it's $24.99 a month. But if you're like me, cautious, you could sign up for 1 month and try it out and see if it's beneficial for you, and then switch to the yearly. You really do get a good saving. But the good thing is, you do get a 7-day trial. Another caveat for you, the only thing is, you will need to put in your credit card details, but they do offer a refund within the first 7 days. So you can use it for 7 days. If it's not your cup of tea, you just simply cancel, and they will cancel your subscription for you before you are charged, which means you can carry on using Wordtune and rewriting your sentences without all of these lovely tools that I'm going to walk you through now. So let me now show you what this looks like using the premium version of Wordtune. Okay, so let's take a look at this same sentence. We might as well stick to it. And I'm going to show you what it looks like if I just click on the casual tone. It will present you with everything that's just casual. You're not seeing any of those lengthy, you know, superfluous words there. It's everything is really casual. So I'm going to choose this one. If you're a purist and don't use AI, then you might be missing out. Nice and simple. It's the one that I prefer to use when I'm writing content, because I just really want to get my point across, which obviously shows you that I could have written that in a way briefer way. But let's bring it back now, and I'll show you what it looks like when you use the formal tone. Okay, those who object to the use of artificial intelligence as a tool for writing may be missing out. I can't help but do the voices when I'm reading the formal tone. And you just click on it, and there you have it. Now let's bring it back, and we are going to expand. We're going to shorten this sentence. When I click on shorten, there you go. If you're an AI purist, you're missing out. You can't get more simple than that. It's still taking my same sentence, the same words, and it's just making it briefer. By the way, if you like tweeting, this is really perfect for you, because you can get your entire idea condensed down into under 280 characters. Okay, so now the final one is going to be the expand. Let's make this a bit longer. So I'm going to click on expand. And there you have it. If you consider yourself a purist and don't utilize AI writing instruments, I can change that back to tools afterwards, the chances are that you have missed out on many great things. Okay, so I could just go here and say, hey, I just want this to be tools. Brilliant. And there it is, a bit longer. When would you use the expand? Well, if you have a really short sentence and you want to make it longer, and you can't think of what to say. So let's do that. Let's take what I had before, the really brief one. Let's see. Oh, where are we going? Hold on. Let's take it back. Sorry, to shorten. Let's make this super short. And now we're going to click on this and expand it. I click on expand. Let's see what it gives us. Well, you're going to be disappointed if you are purist. I'm sorry to say that you're missing out. it takes what you have written and it really, oh, this one has really expanded it, and it just adds more to it. And what I like, by the way, you can see that it will actually highlight in purple the words that it is adding. Okay, so this now is the longer version. This is pretty cool. I like it. The final tool that I want to show you is the Word Finder tool. This is perfect for those moments when you have a word on the tip of your tongue, but you just don't know what it is. So you would just literally come to the end of where you're writing, click on Word Finder, and it will offer up some suggestions. So you could have a writing assistant that understands your words and thoughts, emotions, ideas. Let's go with thoughts. And then let's make sure we have the space there. And I know that the rest of this and fine tunes them. Sorry, the rest of this is and fine tunes them without, and let's say, you don't know what to say. You can say, for example, click on Word Finder and it will offer you some suggestions. Rehearsal is probably what I should have done for this video. And fine tunes them without effort. That pretty much works. Obviously, you have to make sure you have a space there. I'm missing out on that. But this is pretty cool if you just want to expand on something that you have written. You want to add something or you want to change the way you write, but you don't want to use the rewrite function. You want to have more control. You could use the Word Finder functionality there. Now, if I come along here and go to thoughts, because it's already written out, by the way, this is not a good sentence because it's words and thoughts. And however, we have Grammarly and editing to do afterwards. But this is about just getting your ideas out of your head and onto paper, so to speak. If I click on this now, it will offer me some more suggestions. A writing assistant that understands your words and thoughts instantly, easily, quickly, let's choose perfectly. I could then choose to end the sentence there, and that sentence stands really well on its own. I could then choose to say, bear with me. I could do this, sorry, multitasking here. Wordtune tunes them without effort. That could be my sentence change completely there. So anyway, coming to the end of this video, I understand that this is the premium version, but I do want to stress to you, you do not need to sign up for the premium version for Wordtune to really help you. So just to recap what you get with the free version. With the free version, you have the ability to rewrite. You just click on the icon here and you can select and have it rewrite it for you, read through it, make sure it suits your tone, whether you want a longer piece or a shorter piece, you can do that. The other option you have is the suggestions. So if I come along here to perfectly, you can just click on, you can click on suggestions, turn it on, and when you hover over it, it will give you some related words that really understands the context of what you've written. So it will not just throw out a whole, you know, list of different words. It will be relevant to the sentence you've written. And of course, if you are a premium user, you will get the functionality of being able to make your sentence or your paragraph, because it does work with paragraphs, by the way. You can make it casual, formal, you can definitely shorten or expand it. Now, I took these 337 characters. I had it in Wordtune tutorial in my Google Doc, and it wasn't playing ball. But I do want to show you that it does work in Grammarly. So you can click on this entire paragraph and have Wordtune rewrite it for you. So obviously, it depends on the technology. There's something about Google Docs why that wasn't working. And it's also, I've noticed that when I'm using Wordtune a lot, I've had to re-record this video a number of times. Sometimes I need to refresh the Google Doc, but I've never had a problem with this when I'm actually writing and wanting to change an entire paragraph. So you can see that here, it does work with larger pieces of text. So that is it. That is your video tutorial on how to use Wordtune for your writing. And so there you have it. That's Wordtune for you. So do check the link in the description, get it installed and start using it
But do be sure to come back and let me know in the comments what you thought of Wordtune. So until the next video, happy Wordtune.